inauguration. Inauguration comes from the Latin inauguratio, meaning consecration, in the sense of obtaining divine sanction for carrying out some office, duty, or action. The main root of the word augur refers to a Roman diviner or soothsayer who would interpret the will of the gods through omens, by the observation of the flight of birds or other natural phenomena. Hence, if our own inaugurations were determined by avian indicators, we would undoubtedly have inaugurated Bernie Sanders 4 years ago. Inauguration in the modern sense refers to the formal introduction or recognition of some important office or event. It no longer retains its religious or prophetic connotation. But that doesn't mean that modern inaugurations have not had elements of religious-level fanaticism. The inauguration of U.S. President Andrew Jackson in 1829 marked a turning point in U.S. politics. Unlike previous presidents who represented a small class of political elites, Jackson was the first truly populist president, whose power consisted in the adoration of the common people. And so, during his inauguration, Jackson opened the doors of the White House itself to his thronging crowds of supporters, and they stormed into it, destroying fine china, carpets, and furniture. Jackson himself escaped through a window, and the crowd was at length only coaxed out by being offered free whiskey on the White House lawn. The nature and attendance of inaugurations has continued to play a significant role in the self-representation of political figureheads, whether they make that representation accurately or in exaggerated fashion. And now, as we enter another turning point or returning point in our political history, we must be on our guard not to imbue it with empty hope or vain mysticism as we inaugurate it. Is this a moment for ecstatic celebration or guarded caution? What do the omens say? Inauguration.